गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट चिल्ड्रन, लेट स्टार्ट अ बैंकिंग कॉन्सेप्ट फ्रॉम चैप्टर नंबर 4. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दैट बैंक इज अ फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन विच प्रोवाइड क्रेडिट टू द कस्टमर. नाउ व्हाई वी कॉल इट अ फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन, बिकॉज इट डील इन मनी एंड इन फाइनेंस. द बेसिक फंक्शन विच इज डन बाय बैंक इज दैट बैंक एक्सेप्ट मनी फ्रॉम द कस्टमर as a form of deposit and repay this money on the demand of a customer. In this process, bank earn a margin on profit by lending money on a form of interest rate. So basically we can define banking or bank that bank is basically an institution which provide credit to its customer. This we have already done into the previous video. So the next is the types of bank. So we have basically four type of bank on the basis of their different function, that is commercial bank, cooperative bank, specialized bank, central bank. We have learned all these four bank deeply. Today I'll be just giving a quick review or quick revision of this. Commercial bank, main work of commercial bank is that institute which deal in a form of money, right? It means the main work of commercial bank is to deal out in money. Now, commercial bank is governed by Indian Banking Regulation Act 1949. This type of bank, children, commercial bank basically deposit money from the public, which they have a surplus money, and lend out these money for the purpose of investment. Commercial bank have two types basically. They can be in a form of public sector also, or they can be in a form of private sector also. Now the next type of bank was cooperative bank. Now children, cooperative bank are governed by provision of State Cooperative Societies Act. Now cooperative bank main work is to provide credit to the member of the cooperative society bank. Next bank we have specialized bank. Children, as the name is saying, that this type of bank provide a special type of unique activities or special functions. Now what are these special functions which is conducted or organized by specialized bank? These banks basically dealt in the foreign exchange. They basically work into the foreign monies. They basically dealt the activity of industrial bank for the development. They basically dealt the activity of export and import. Just because of these unique nature, we call it as specialized bank. Next bank we have central bank. Now everyone know the central bank of our country is RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India. Now central bank main work is to supervise, control and regulate all the activity of different commercial bank within the country. It means we can say that central bank is the head bank of all the bank which are available in our country. The central bank is the one who regulate, control all the activities of other bank. So these are the different four bank which we are going to discuss into type of bank. Now today we will be talking about the function of commercial bank. It means what are the different function which is conducted by commercial bank. As I have already told you, commercial bank basically means an institute which deal into money. Dealing into money basically means it accept deposit of money from public. The people, those who have surplus money, what they did, they deposit that month surplus money or extra money into bank, right? And whenever they have a demand, they lend out this money from the bank. So this is the main work which is done by a commercial bank. So the first main function of commercial bank will be acceptance of deposit. It means accepting the deposit of public, accepting the deposit of customer is the main function of commercial bank. You can see it from here also. Deposit are the basis of loan operation, since bank are both borrower and lender of money. It means bank accept money from whom? From the customer. Those who have surplus money, bank accept that their money and provide money to whom? to the lender, lender working as a lender basically means the people, those who have shortage of money, they come and take the money as a form of loan from the bank. So that time bank is working as a lender, right? It means when bank is accepting deposit from the customer who have surplus money, that time bank is working as a borrower of money. And when bank is providing loan to the people who have shortage of money, that time bank is playing a role of lender of money. So that is the reason we said that bank play both the role here, as a borrower also and the lender also. As a borrower, they pay interest to whom? To the customer. It means if somebody is depositing money into our bank, we have to provide interest to that person. And in the same case, as a lender, if we are providing loan to the customer, we will be charging interest to that person. So this difference between giving interest and taking interest, right, that will be called as the margin of profit of a bank. So the first function which is conducted by a bank is accepting the deposit from the customer who have surplus of money. It means jinke paas extra money hai, unki money ko bank mein deposit karna, accept karna, bank ka first function ho gaya. Next function of bank is lending of fund. Now as once we accept the money, we deposit the money into the bank, our second major activity of commercial bank is to lend out the money. Or lending the money basically means providing loan and advance out of money received through deposit. It means the people, those who required loan, providing that loan or providing that advance to these people, that is the another job of bank. It means one side, bank is accepting money of those people who have surplus money, that is called acceptance of deposit. And in the second function, bank is also providing lending funds to those people who required loan and who required advance. So this is the second function which is done by bank. Now third function of bank is providing check facility to its customer. Now bank render a very important services to their customer by collecting their check drawn on other bank. The check is the most developed credit instrument, a unique feature and function of bank for withdrawal of deposit. It is most convenient and inexpensive medium of exchange. It means the third function which bank did is that bank also provide a check facility to the customer. Check facility basically means that instead of having a cash transaction, bank also allow facility of check to the customer. Now when we talk about check can be known as a very important credit instrument, right? This have a unique features by which from any bank the check can be withdrawn. Now when we talk about check here, there are two types of check: the bearer check, which are encashable immediately at bank counter. It means bearer check means a check which can be easily encashable immediately. It means if you have a check which you will go into the bank counter or immediately can be withdrawn, aap immediately usko cash mein withdrawn kar sakte hain, that check is known as bearer check. And the second is cross check. Cross check basically means which are to be deposited only in the pay account. It means second check is cross check. Cross check basically means you have to deposit that check into the pay account. You cannot withdraw the cash immediately in that case. So this is the third function which is provided by bank, that bank also provide a check facility. Next is remittance of fund. Now this is the another function which is done by bank, is that bank has a silent function of commercial bank, is providing the facility of fund transfer from one place to another or one account of interconnectivity of branches. It means remittance of fund basically means you can say it transfer of funds. This is the another function which bank did, is that the money can be easily transferred from one account to another account, or it can be easily transferred from one place to another places. So this is basically possible because of the interconnectivity of the bank branches. right? We can easily transfer our fund from one bank to another bank, or we can easily transfer our fund from one account to another account. So transfer of fund is also one of the main important function of commercial bank. Next is allied services. Now children, all these four function which we have read, that is acceptance of deposit, lending of funds, providing check facilities, transfer of funds. So these all are related with money, right? Now in after these four function, bank also provide allied services. This services can be by the help of bank, you can able to pay out the different type of bills also. We can also able to get the locker facilities also, where we can keep our gold safe. We can also able to get underwriting services also. And by the help of bank, even we can also able to engage in lots of other share and debentures or other instruction purchasing and selling functions also. Bank also provide us the insurance facilities or payment of insurance, payment of premium, collection of dividends. So these all other or extra services are called as allied services. So this is about function of commercial bank. Let's have a revision again. Commercial bank provide you first function, that is acceptance of deposit. The second function was lending of fund, means providing loan. The third function was check facility, providing the check facility to its customer. And these checks are into two forms. The bearer check, which can be easily encashable from the counter, and the cross check, which cannot be immediately encashable from the counter. It required first to deposit it into the pay account. The fourth function of bank or commercial bank was transfer of funds. Commercial bank also provide us the facility of transferring fund from one place to another place, or from one account to another account, in an interconnectivity branches manner. And the last function of bank was providing allied services, means the bank also provides lots of unique services also, like bill payment can be done by bank, locker facilities provided by bank, underwriting services are provided by bank, the premium of insurance can also be done by the help of bank. And even we can also able to buy and sell our share and debentures by the help of bank. So this is all about the different function which is done or provided by commercial bank. Now next concept here we have e-banking. Now e-banking concept is these days highlighted very much, and most of the people are going through with e-banking. E-banking can be easily understand children by internet banking. It means where we are doing the banking process by the help of internet, that is called as internet banking. We can say internet banking and e-commerce also somewhere linked with each others, right? Because both of them, what they have done, e-commerce has completely transferred the world into a digital global village. Means e-commerce ke through pure ke pure world ko ek chota sa global village bana diya e-commerce ne. All are linked with each other. Right now you are sitting here, from here you can search out the data of anywhere, any countries. So this is what? This is possible by the help of e-commerce. Now let's see e-banking definition. So in simple term, internet banking means any user with a PC and a browser can get connected to the bank website to perform any of the virtual banking function and avail of any the bank services. It means internet banking kya hai? Internet banking means a banking process by which any user, by the help of using PC, personal computer, and browsers mean internet or network, can be able to connect with any bank website and can perform any virtual banking function, any online banking functions, or it can take any online bank services, that is called as internet banking. In simple term, you can say internet banking means where we use internet for going through with the banking process or for utilizing the banking. We called it internet or e-banking. Now children, when we talk about internet banking is service इंटरनेट बैंकिंग और ई बैंकिंग इज़ दैट सर्विस प्रोवाइडेड बाय मेनी बैंक. दिस बेसिकली से दैट इन दिस न्यू डिजिटल मार्केट प्लेस बैंक एंड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैव स्टार्टेड प्रोवाइडिंग सर्विसेज ओवर द इंटरनेट. इट मीन्स राइट नाउ बिकॉज वी आर वर्किंग इन टू अ डिजिटल वर्ल्ड. So, what the bank and other institution has done, they have started providing us services into internet. These type of services provided by the bank on the internet is called as e-banking. This is the another definition of internet banking or e-banking, that when bank provides services on internet, these type of services are called as e-banking. Now, the lower transaction cost is the main advantage of e-banking. How? When we are going through with the process of e-banking, the transaction costs are lower. The reason behind this is that the person can sit at their home only, and from the home only they can go through with the any banking transaction. So the cost of incurring that transaction is low. Now children, we will be going through with the benefit of e-banking. It means that if we are using internet banking or online banking, what are the different benefit which we will be getting? So it's very easy that e-banking facilitate digital payment and promote transparency in financial statement. Reason behind that is that when we don't have a system of e-banking, jab tak e-banking ka system nahi tha, what we are doing, we are going to bank, we are depositing money there, we are withdrawing money from there. Whatever details we required, our balance, we have to go to bank to know these details, right? So transparency was not there. We have to go to bank for getting all those details. But in case of e-banking now, by the help of e-banking system, anytime any user can able to go through with any details of its bank account. So the transparency is there, which is done only after the help of e-banking. Next is that e-banking provide 24 hours 365 day a year services to the customer of the bank. Now before e-banking, we have a limited hour of banking. It means 10 to 5, 10 to 4, 10 to 3. That is the time when customer can come to bank and do whatever he want to do, either submitting of money, depositing of money, lending of money, right? But in case of e-banking, now the bank are open for 24 hour online, 365 day in a year. Anytime you can go through with any transaction into the bank. Next is customer can make some of the permitted transaction from office or house or while traveling into mobile or telephone. It means in case of e-banking, now you don't need to come to bank for doing a small transaction also. There are certain transaction which is permitted on internet also. So even after sitting at your home, while you are traveling, while you are using mobile telephone, you can go through with these transaction also. Next is it inculcates a sense of finance discipline by recording each and every transaction. Next benefit what e-banking is providing to us is that whatever transaction we did in e-banking, each and every transaction is recorded into a bank also, and even the form, or you can say your mobiles also, by which we did the transaction. Next is greater customer satisfaction by offering unlimited access to the bank, not limited by the wall of branch, and less risk and greater security to the customer as they can avoid traveling with cash. Now next advantage what e-banking is giving, that the customer satisfaction is greater here. Why? Because the services or offer provided by e-banking is unlimited access. Now you can access to e-banking or bank website anytime. There is no limitation of timing there, and the more security is also there because you don't need to travel with the cash. We have a lots of another form or plastic money cards. We have lost a website online by which we can able to transact money from one account to another account. So security is also there, and plus unlimited access is given by bank by using the internet services. So customer is more satisfied here. So this is about the all benefit which is provided by e-banking to its customer. Now next is what are the bank also stand to gain by e-banking? It means what are the different advantage which even bank is also getting after using e-banking services into the bank. So the first advantage will be e-banking provide competitive advantage to the bank. It means just because of e-banking, they have got a competitive place or a competitive atmosphere which is providing advantage to the bank also. Now each and every bank can able to know that they have a facility of internet over way, they can able to attract their more and more customer by providing them better services. Next is e-banking provide unlimited network to the bank and is not limited to the number of branches. Any PC connected to a modem and a telephone having an internet connection can provide cash withdrawal need of the customer. Now next advantage which e-banking giving to bank is that is that e-banking is providing unlimited network to the bank. Now any customer can able to withdraw money and for that the bank does not need to open. They can able to do this, the customer can able to withdraw money without the bank opening by online and the data can be automatically saved into the bank transaction. Next is load on branches can be considerably reduced by establishing centralized database and by taking over some of the accounting function. It means now the load which was there earlier into the bank that is also reduced because whatever transactions are can be done from a customer online. These all transactions the customer did online and automatically these all data get saved into a centralized database. So the load of the bank branches has been reduced here. So these all are the advantage which e-banking is giving to the bank. Thank you. In the next video, we will learn about insurance.